Chamisa declared December a national month for preserving the environment. You know that Zimbabwe had cyclone Idai at the beginning of the year, and we had a terrible season last year. And we're faced with yet another likely terrible season. The president, the young president, is concerned about the future of the globe, he's concerned about the future of the earth. And so he said, let's conscientize our society to plant and preserve trees, and that's what he went to Marangira to kick start. It makes sense that we do that as a young generation. We ought to look after Mother Earth. That's all we've got. We've got any other planet. Unfortunately, we just have one planet. And it doesn't matter what we do when we do it. The government, the energy government, all that stuff, things like that. And that's the reality. But I want to warn, as none of the effective, banning the MDC is not a viable route to take. There is no clear path to victory for them. They must be very careful about that. This over-reliance on violence is not going to succeed in any way. I think we can talk about that rather than divert attention to talk about it with actions. Well, look, he lives in a dictatorship. He has always been as unsafe as most Zimbabweans. He is awake to that fact, and he will live out his days of struggle, as you say, struggling to lead the people that have elected him and to get this country to a better place. He has been doing this for over 25 years of his adult life, so I think that he's going to continue doing that. He's unfazed. He's shocked that his country is going in this direction, but knows that the struggle goes on. The hope will move down in the situation. It's a matter of his ultimate responsibility for the activities of his police officers. Well, they can try and kill him, but they don't kill him. And he is